weird. Manipulative.
Shallow.
Thoughtless.
Jealousy.
Annoying.
Selfish.
Obnoxious.
Gay.
Truthful.
Loud.
Funny.
Dreamer.
Beautiful. Creative.
Inclusive.
Confident.
Supportive.
Spontaneous. Determined. Diverse. Brave.
Empathetic.
Playful.
Outgoing. Funny.
Friendly.
Teamwork.
Enthusiastic.
Team.
Talented. Family.
In the patient, and I went into the auditorium, and there are curtains in the auditorium that you are not supposed to touch.
So I wrapped myself up in them. And in the curtains, there is a smell from the very first show that I was ever in called Mary Poppins. They had a fog machine, and the fog smells like waffles. So I was in waffle-smelling curtains, and I realized in that moment how much I absolutely love this place and how much family and home I feel in our world.
And it was a running stream, and it was my first lead role, so I was super excited. I put like everything into it. And then when it came to opening night, I was terrified that no one would like the show. But then, this is me, I came out after the show, and I heard people talking about how much they enjoyed it and how funny they thought it was. And I realized that theater is good for people and that it's right for people's needs. And that was just a huge moment for me where I realized that theater can help people.
This is me. I'm looking really good today. It was just kind of an off day for me. Early morning seminary, a lot of bad news. And so I wasn't really talking to anybody. And out of the blue, Mary came over and she gave me a hug and gave me how much she cared about me. And that really made me feel loved. And my dad's part more than just a class, I was part of the community.
Sophomore year, I had the fortunate opportunity.
Smile like me.
To be in our region play, Devil Man, Pathological Killer. It was so much fun. I was cast as the killer, so yeah. but it was such a demanding and difficult role to play, and so you can imagine a little sophomore getting in this part and then realizing that, oh crap, this is gonna be difficult, and I'm not gonna get very far in this. Well, when Sid came around. Our show was a success, and I had received Best Supporting Actor in state. And it was overwhelming for me to have received an award for something like this. And the amount of love I received from all my other peers and classmates, it was also very overwhelming. And that's when I decided that I'm going to do this for the rest of my life, and I will do this for the rest of my life.
Called energy darts, where you basically look the other person in the eye and shoot energy towards them. You have to receive it, and so it's all about like putting down your wall so you can connect with your acting partner. That's something that I've always struggled with. And so I was doing this activity with my best friend, and I really felt the energy. Like it was this really weird feeling, and it felt warm. It was crazy, and it was so cool to finally know what it feels like to put down your walls like that. And it completely changed who I was as a performer. And since then, I've completely opened up.
Nervous, and he walked into the theater room first thing in the morning and met the lovely Hannah Warden, who was the theater president at the time. I looked up to her in every way possible and imaginable. All I wanted to do was just like Hannah Warden. Fast forward to senior year now, and I'm failing like three classes, and there's like 2 weeks left of school, and I'm stressed. I'm not Hannah Warden. But auditions for center stage roll around, and Malia Warden walks up to me and tells me that she wants to be just like me when I'm in theater four, just like I want to be, just like her sister. And I know in one way or another, I have become who I was meant to be.
Like, bite on the and it was awkward for everyone involved, trust me, I
three.
Ding. Alright, this is me, this one's me, this one's Kartrip Perkins, and this is the two of us doing our musical theater piece this year at our region and state competition. This was a neat experience for me because I have a lot of fun performing, but I'm also like pretty insecure about myself. I think I'm funny, I have no idea if everyone else thinks I'm funny, but I do. And so being able to do this goofy song with my best friend, and not only just have a lot of fun with it, but take first place at both the region and state levels and just get such an overwhelming success with it and have everyone love it so much was really comforting to me and let me really feel like what I do.
So my sophomore year, I transferred here from a charter school, and I had gotten into MDT, and I was feeling really good about myself, and I got cast in some small lead roles, and I was like, junior year is going to be awesome, I'm going to get cast, it's going to be great, and Flynn was like, psych! And so, junior year came around, and I was like, I'm going to audition, and I'm going to get cast, and Flynn was like, psych! And this repeated, and I ended up getting cast in absolutely nothing my junior year. And the MDT musical rolled around, which was Urinetown, and I was super excited, and I was like, this is my chance! And once again, Flynn was like, psych! And so I got cast as the old lady in Urinetown. I was literally like the last name on the cast list, last name in the program. I was like the very last person. And I thought about this, there's two ways that I could take this. I could either be really negative and really put on self-pity, or I could choose to see the best in it. And I ended up creating this monstrosity of a character, and I really learned the importance of acting well your part, there all the honor lies. And this is my mom, who I'm grateful has never been embarrassed to be related to me.
Last year, we did a unit about stage combat, and Clint was teaching us all how to properly slap someone, and I just happened to be the closest person to him, so he used me as a volunteer. So I got up there on stage, and as he went to slap me, I did it wrong. And I guess it was just kind of mocking Clint, because he was making such a big deal out of it. And as I did that, he kind of just looked at me and went, no! And I thought it was hilarious, absolutely hilarious. And to me, the whole thing just demonstrates how that's the beauty of theater, that it makes even the most little insignificant moments just all that much more enjoyable.
Unwanted adopted child. So what I ended up doing in one day is walking in late, and I was feeling lonely and sad like always, and I was like, oh shoot, they're looking at me. They're just scrutinizing for being late and all that, but instead, they ended up telling me how much they loved me and giving me compliments, and that's when I realized I was the only one ever making myself feel like I didn't belong.
Opportunities because I just took the chance, and so it was just this overwhelming moment of gratitude for just being brave for once and doing what I needed to.
I didn't really just do theater because I had friends there. I did it because, you know, theater was a fun class. This was another class for me, I guess. But mostly throughout this year, throughout like small things, like people just talking to me or complimenting me or just laughing at my jokes, I realized that theater is not just a class, it's a community, a family. And I realized all those little things helped make me figure that out.
For me, a big moment when I really felt like part of the theater family was during callbacks at Cinderella. Mystery had us all off practicing the song and just enjoying ourselves. And so, you know, everybody was singing their hearts out. And I tried things that I'd never tried before and I didn't think that I could do. And I realized that my boundaries are self-imposed and I could really be part of the theater family.
Don't end up in jail.
Next!
Everyone, I'm Connor Lambert. I'm going to be serving an LDS mission and then returning to attend UNITE, the Utah State University.
Good job. Are you ready?
I am Tate Morgan, and I will be going to Solid Community College this fall and probably working at Hale Center Theater for the season.
Nice. Next! Hi, I'm Ari Bagwell. I'm going to cosmetology school in the fall, after which I will marry Zachary Levi. And if that doesn't work out, then I'll marry my best friend, Chelsea. Thank you. Thank you for coming to class today, Ari.
Hi, my name is Tanner Summons, and this summer I will be touring around Utah performing a stunt show, and then in fall I'm going to attend Westminster where I'm going to study theatrical performance and dance.
Next! Hi, I'm Sophia Jensen, and in the fall I'll be attending CLIC, where I will later move on to university to major in forestry with an emphasis in botany.
And in the fall, I'll be attending the University of Utah, and then hopefully after a year, I can transfer to none other than the Ohio State University.
That's very swell, Eden. Did you guys know he likes orange? Mikey, are you ready now? I don't care how dumb you think this activity is, but we're all sharing.
Ron?
Your papers have been sent to headquarters.
You deposited the cash!
Mr. Williamson!
Your cash was deposited last week, but we're completely covered no matter what.
You deposited the cash!
Not under my watch, no.
Darn it all! Gee, Walker's wrong, this is somebody's boo-boo!
You stupid meanie butt! You, Mr. Williamson, I'm talking to you! You just wasted $8,000, poopy head!
Too many crickets!
$8,000 and one flipping Chrysler! What do you have to say to that? What do you have to say to that, you jerky, jerky, jerk, jerk? You gosh darn piece of horse manure! How did this happen? Huh? You son of a gun! You son of a gun!
Wow! That was amazing!
Oh, it only gets more amazing, Tom! The script cleaner file now doesn't just clean up language. It has hundreds of other uses.
Hundreds of?
Have you ever heard of William Shakespeare?
No, I haven't.
Neither did I. Until a researcher's in Warwick, he's a writer of some local renown. But
let me tell you something, Tom. Renown or no renown, we have received letters every day from our customers who are very much concerned that this Shakespeare sometimes includes violence in his plays.
My goodness.
My sentiments, exactly. Which is why the script cleaner 5000 was developed specifically to scrub away even the bloodiest of scenes. Let's take a look.
Boy! This shall not excuse the injuries that theft has caused me. Therefore, turn and draw.
I do protest I never injured thee, but to love thee better than thou canst devise. So thou shalt know the reason for my love. And so do Capulet, which may my tender as dearly as my own, be satisfied.
Oh, call this honorable blasphemy! All Sagat cares your way.
What is thou with thee?
Good King of Cats, nothing but one of your nine lives.
I am for you.
Tell you, Tom, I'm holding the truth. And lying is not what America is about. America is about
Your boys are dead, killed by their own mother.
No! No! What are you saying? You have destroyed me!
They are dead. You have told us your thoughts on that fact.
You in there! Open the bar on the door at once so I see my two dead sons and their murderer, that woman on whom I shall exact my revenge!
Why are you shaking the doors like that? Try and find the children in me, the one who killed them. Well, stop trying. If you want something from me, then say so. But you'll never have it within your own grasp.
It's beautiful.
Now, I know what some of you may be thinking. What if a member of my cast happened to be a vegetarian?
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Well, no need to fret, because the script cleaner 5000 is always a step ahead.
You in there, remove the bar on the door once so I'm missing with two dead sons and their murder. That woman on who has exact my revenge.
Why are you shaking the doors like that? Trying to find the children in me? The one who killed them? Well, stop trying. If you want something from me, then say so. But you'll never have me within your grasp.
Incredible.
I'm telling you, Tom, this product is so wonderful, so incredible, and so effective in removing the offensive parts of plays that you'd have to be crazy to pass this opera.
Oh, okay. Now, Shelley, let me ask you a question. What about scenes that have, relations between men and women?
I'm glad you asked, Tom. As we all may know, many plays contain scenes involving nudity in the act of bedtime intimacy! And as we all know, there is no place for this on a high school stage.
Because high schoolers would never participate in such acts!
From Kenneth Lonergan's critically acclaimed play, This Is Our Youth. The senior about to witness involves two young adults in 1982 and their experience with drugs.
And I hope that the rest of America is too.
Me too, Tom. Me too.